What's up, guys? Welcome to the Corridor Cast podcast.
The only source for real news.
What's up, everybody? It's Corridor Cast.
Award-winning Pulitzer Prize journalism and visual effects and some janky guitar playing.
Janky guitar.
Some strums of a lifetime.
And some jokes that you may wish to tell to other people.
Yeah.
If rehearsed.
Just cite your sources, you know? It's important.
Yeah, let's come out with a joke book.
We should have like an intro joke book. Just
have you ever had a joke book and been satisfied when you read it?
Yeah.
I have yet to.
I've felt sad at the end. It's been more like a downward spiral kind of thing. Like that's at my lowest point is when I'm going to read joke books.
Yeah.
I watched some.
And you have no friends.
You just need.
And you're like, just I need some jokes to make
Valentine's
me laugh.
Day
and
jokes.
You open those. You rifle through those pages.
Somebody, please give me some jokes.
I'm trying to answer the door and laugh as many times as possible.
Come
that's
on.
A knock knock joke.
I was with you. At the door.
Okay.
It's me. It's a friend to help you.
Turns out it's a friend to help you.
You've got problems. It's
knock, knock,
an intervention.
Guys. Knock, knock. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Your friend.
My friend who?
Your friend to help you through your anxiety and depression.
Please, come in.
Thank you.
Just the story continues.
Come inside.
I love you and I care about you.
This reminds me of a great podcast idea, which is a one-player D&D game.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Yo, you want to test it out?
How does that work?
Yeah, I was curious too.
All right, you wake up in a dungeon alone, Jordan.
Oh, I'm the one player, I guess.
And
here
you,
we go.
Wait, you feel yourself and you realize you have nothing but loincloths on. The room is completely dark.
Normal business day for me.
Cloth for your
So now in this game, you would say something like, I feel my way around the room to find maybe a torch or a door. You know,
okay. Yeah. Probably start by saying I take off the loincloth.
What,
to
really?
Be honest, yeah, if we're going to be realistic.
It's the first thing you do.
It's in the way.
As you put the loincloth on the ground, it's immediately consumed by rats.
Oh, good lord! What have I done?
Who knew?
And I have no one to turn to. No one can give me their loincloth because I'm in this alone.
Hold on. The rats are attacking you.
Oh, this is awful. I try to leave the room.
Roll initiative. As you move to the door, you draw attacks of opportunity from 10 rats. They've all hit you. You're dead.
I know you spent 3 hours creating this character and another 3 doing the background, but
I'm starting to see the allure.
That's gonna be it.
You know?
Yeah,
it was just a quick thrill there. Just a quick, like, exciting adventure.
Well, I gave him a show on my way out, you know,
to rat him. Hey, speaking of
Do me next.
All right.
Don't take off your loincloth.
Okay. All right.
Just a hint. All
right, let's go.
It's noon, and you find yourself at the entrance of a tavern because there is someone who's written you a letter saying they're in deep trouble, and they're going to meet you here and pay you 100 gold pieces to do a task. Ooh. So you stand in front of the tavern. It's a cloudy day out, and it's quiet.
Well, I immediately turn around and walk the opposite direction because no one needs money in D&D, right?
Yeah, and with inflation, 100 gold, it won't even buy a loaf of bread anymore.
All right, so come on. Which way do you walk?
Directly the opposite way.
All right, so you walk out of town and you've now entered the forest. And
you're immediately
roll perception check.
Rolled. Right,
what did you get?
I don't know, like a 6.
There's a pack of wolves looking at you.
This is my question right now. Is were there to be a pack of wolves inside the tavern as well? Would it have mattered if I left or stayed in the tavern? What do I do? Do I have anything?
Yeah, what is he wearing?
What's on your inventory? I don't know.
What's in my?
I don't keep track of this crap.
Okay, I'll keep track of it. I have.
Yeah, you keep track of your own inventory.
I have a harp.
Oh,
you have a harp?
That was a poor choice. Oh.
Are you clothed? Are you wearing clothes?
I just have a harp.
All
right. I'm rolling with Jordan. Jordan has a great strap. You don't need clothes. You don't need money. You just need a harp.
Exactly.
You're naked in the forest carrying around a full-sized harp.
Yes. We're going for realism.
Like a seated French harp.
How are you going to keep the weight down?
Thank you.
For or is it like a is it like heavy. A King David harp, you know, like a small one?
No, it's a full-sized harp.
I'm curious,
it has wheels though.
Oh nice. What's so the game plan around. For the harp? I'm curious where this is going.
So the wolves are getting closer. You're running out of time.
Certainly they are, but they're about to be soothed.
Oh.
In a sweet they're about to be bathed in a melody of harp playing.
Oh nice.
They have now reached they're 30 feet away from here.
Roll agility.
Are you rolling the harp? All right.
Dwindling on my
okay, so the sound of the harp makes one of them sit down.
Oh.
And it makes a second one sit down. There's three more, though. They still want to kill you.
Oh, boy.
Keep playing.
So it's worth those fingers.
Even more soothingly.
Flick those strings.
And make direct eye contact with the ones that
yes.
are.
All right,
they come exactly closer. Yeah. They're coming closer, and it looks like they're about to ready. They're going to attack you, so roll initiative.
Okay. Come on, baby.
Nat 20.
Nat 20. All right.
Let's go.
You get to go first.
Keep strumming, man.
How close are they?
They're 20 feet away.
Okay. It's going to be the fastest I've ever played harp in my life.
All right.
It's very loud.
You soothe another one, but the other two moves run up to you, and one bites at your feet.
Okay.
Does a 13 hit?
No.
It doesn't? Okay, the other one bites at your legs. Does a 19 hit? Probably.
No.
Probably.
Wow. No. Very thick skin.
Wow, this is getting very interesting.
So, you're naked,
the table's
right?
turned.
They're both biting at your legs right now.
They are. Turns out.
Okay, it's your turn again.
I'm gonna keep playing the harp.
Yes.
Even more aggressively as I've ever played a harp.
Okay.
My fingers are bleeding a little bit because of how much I'm playing.
All right. Well, one fails its check and succumbs to the soothing, but the other one doesn't and tries to bite your legs again.
Just gnawing on your leg.
Does a 25 hit?
I'm really proud you made
God
it.
God damn it! No, it doesn't.
What are you made out of?
Steel.
Yeah, right.
I made out of harp materials.
You're wrapped in harp wires.
I'm actually wrapped in harp wires.
This is getting way more interesting now.
Yeah.
This is getting way more interesting.
And you strangle 25 doesn't hit?
No, of course not.
All right, it's your turn again.
Of course not. Well,
I feel like you've committed to the playing at this point.
The strategy remains.
Yeah, it's working.
And it seems to be working pretty well. So I'm just going to keep going until my fingers are kind of just nubs.
All right. So the intense intense music playing sends vibrations into the ground. You realize that you're over a sinkhole and it gives way and you have to jump out of the way. So roll me a dexterity saving throw.
Okay.
To jump away from the sinkhole.
I got a one.
It's got to be
16
or higher.
You fail and fall into the sinkhole and you are dealt 50 points of damage. Are you dead?
No.
What?
No, of course not. No, are you serious?
Started.
I made out of harp material. Did you not understand?
All right, I don't want to play.
You're
this
like
game.
A level. You're like a level.
And that's how you win D&D, right?
That's how you win D&D.
He won.
I'm really proud of you.
You piss off the DM.
I'm really proud
with
of
made
you.
Up bullshit.
You're like a level 8 human fighter that somehow learned music along the way and has no weapons and is naked.
That's
why I don't need clothes.
He's kind of like godlike.
Yeah, that's why I don't need clothes.
Yeah. So wait, what kind of is your character like a god?
You're like the blue god, like a blue one with a.
Well,
floppy.
Shit! I probably should have let you should have told me this before we started the game. I would have given you something a little harder.
Yeah.
So well, wait, let me get this straight. You're a god, and you went to a tavern to get gold.
That's why
no,
I left.
Away from it.
Monetary
left.
Values are insignificant.
He
to
has
left.
His heart.
Yeah. I don't need earthly material things.
Well, we can play again later, but we'll start from that pit you fell in.
Okay,
you're in this pit.
Sounds great.
Right,
that will be the starting point. So yeah, feel
let
free
me
to
go.
Prepare for that.
Let me go.
Oh, Jake wants to go?
Yeah, I want to go. Everyone's gone now.
Yeah.
All right, Jake. It's your 300th birthday. And you go to the realm of clouds to celebrate it because a few cloud giants have invited you to celebrate in their domain. And so you ride a majestic winged hybrid eagle horse type of Pegasus thingy, and it lands on a cloud where you dismount. And before you, you see three cloud giants, and they have a birthday cake that's bigger than your house.
Are they made of clouds, the giants?
I say, this is the best birthday I've ever had. How should we celebrate?
They say, the best way to celebrate is by eating this cake right away. But before we eat this cake, you have to blow out your 300 birthday candles in one blow, or else we'll be offended.
No. Okay. I cast
Thunderwave and I blow out the candles with Thunderwave.
Oh, shit!
Ooh. Oh, he's bringing terminology to the game.
Wow,
right.
He plays the game, actually.
As someone who died naked and alone in the dark, I'm impressed.
All three cloud giants are very impressed with this skill, and they put the birthday cake in front of you, and they say, shall we cut it?
Yes, please.
All right, and they take out a giant axe, and they slice you a piece off, and it's about 10 feet tall and 15 feet long.
Mm. I take out a bollocks knife, and I just start eating.
Oh, there's a storm coming. It starts to rain.
Okay.
And it's making the cake very soggy.
Oh.
I don't want to offend these guys, so I'm still eating.
Don't
smart.
Stop.
roll initiative.
Are you against what?
Oh, you offended us.
The cloud giants are done with this.
Against the cloud giants?
Oh, yeah. Oh, sorry. No, the cloud evaporates from beneath you. Roll a dex save to grab onto the cake.
Okay.
But it's so soggy.
It's an 8. It's an 8 plus it's an my eight. Modifier. So it's 15.
Fail. You fall 2,000 feet to the ground.
Okay. It was a 15 with my modifier.
You lose 1,000 hit points. Are you still alive?
No. I'm dead.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
There's rats down there.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
You fall all the way down and where you land next to a loincloth and a bunch of rats feasting on a corpse.
Loinclothless corpse. Thank you very much.
In my last dying words, I turn to him and I go, you in for the same thing, huh?
Yeah. Single player D&D.
I don't even know why I went to sleep there. That felt like a poor choice.
Anyways.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, we'll talk about we can dissect these campaigns.
Yeah.
Yeah, I spent a while prepping them.
That's great.
Yeah, it sounds like it.
Really does sound like it. That's fun. That's a lot of fun.
All right. Well,
that was way
was
more
a nice...
fun than I thought it'd be.
Yeah, that's actually a lot.
Normally when I think about single player D&D, it's just what is that anyways? It's like I'm going to play an imaginary game, and I want you to guess what's going on in it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
I want you to just refuse to die
at
every
really
turn.
This is two-player D&D, though, because you're still DMing.
Yeah, the players have to outnumber the DM, or else it's not a game.
Yeah.
Right.
It's just a twisted, sadistic, like, thought experiment.
Yeah, kind of. Right. It is. It just feels like torture a little bit.
Like top 10 games you can play in your head by yourself.
All right, it's like, yeah, you find yourself in a car. What do you do? Doesn't matter. Car
okay,
blows
hold
up,
on.
You're dead. It's like, it's like that's fun.
Car blows up, dealing you 35 points of damage. Are you dead?
Yeah. It's like, oh. Just see that coming.
Are we going to do a second version of that book?
Yeah, totally. No, maybe.
Yeah.
Totally not. Come on.
At this point, it's like, there's not
David,
enough time.
David could write it. David could write most of it.
I know. I told him to.
Yeah,
I requested that he does that, so, but he's not
he's
doing
a busy
it.
Boy.
He's
busy. A busy bee.
He's busy.
Yeah,
he's busy. No fault of his own. Well, actually, 100% of his own. He's doing very well for himself.
Yeah,
right on.
How dare he?
Anyways,
that's all a really right. cool
well,
book cover.
Hey,
I'll say that.
On that note,
that's all I got.
On the note of projects, D&D, and all the rest, I was going through. Well, because before this podcast started, we were talking about how you don't want to play yourself.
We were saying that. Yeah.
It took some work to get Jordan to understand that there's a distinguishment between playing yourself and playing with yourself.
Yeah.
And those are two different,
it's a line of
very
different
distinct things.
Though don't
sometimes
get them
could probably be one and the same. I suppose if you're playing with yourself, you could also be playing yourself.
Yeah. If you're wasting time.
Circumstances
could be doing other things
and
that are important.
Depending on location, you know. Be careful.
Yeah, or,
be careful.
Or depending on location, you could
engaging in a masturbatory exercise could be a waste of time.
In a dark hole full of rats.
Or jail time.
Or jail.
Depending. Yes. Maybe you're. Yeah. You know. But
jail
anyways,
is a waste of time.
Indeed. A lot more of your time.
Is jail the epitome of a waste of time?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's well, literally we're taking your time.
I would say a trash can full of clocks.
Taking the most valuable thing from
it
you.
It wastes
literally.
Your time.
Yeah.
You know, I'll play on words there.
Yeah, yeah.
But
it's interesting.
Like it.
That's cool.
I like it.
Thanks.
I like it. Thank you. Thank you for offering that.
Yeah, clocks aren't obviously time itself. They're just like
It's valid.
Measurement.
Yeah,
it's a metaphor.
You ripped it to pieces. Yep, there it goes.
It's a great metaphor. Thank you. I really liked it, actually, Jordan.
Yeah, I don't want to have to explain how clocks work.
Mm. Yeah.
You know, isn't there time inside?
There's actually time in there.
Yeah. There's time inside every clock.
The source of time. If we simply destroyed all clocks, time would stop.
Yeah.
I'm out of time. Oh, you need a new clock? It's like, yes, please.
Wind that thing back a little bit.
Or that movie with Justin Timberlake.
Just in time.
Yeah. Nick, just in time.
The name is Justin Time.
Is it Justin Time or is it Nick of Time?
There's gonna be a sequel called Nick of Time.
The Nick of Time.
Yeah.
Is that with like
we should start a sub-series about Nick the Time God.
Nick Jonas?
he's made out of time.
He's all clocks. Yeah,
he's literally tiny clocks. You see, you see it on his. When you look at him, he looks like a normal human, but they've actually broken down his cell form.
He's an automaton.
And he's made of tiny clocks.
Many, there's gears.
Yeah,
in case that's how they work. So it would be gears.
He's geared up.
Whatever. I'm glad we sorted this out.
Anyways. To get back to my original point, this was a waste of time.
So, this conversation.
This was definitely a waste of time.
No, this but is my point is like conversation.
I was looking into next year, guys. Next year.
All right, you know what time it is. That's right. It's time for today's podcast sponsor. And this one I am very thankful for because anytime I get the opportunity to talk about good habits, I'm a happy boy, okay? And Quip is the good habits company. That's right, because they believe that good habits lead to good health, okay? And so whether you're talking about what they do, which is oral products and oral care, or you're talking about mental health, physical health, spiritual health, all of those things start with good habits. All right, so what is Quip? What do they do? What do they offer? Well, like I said, Quip delivers everything you need for all your oral care, all the essentials in one easy and convenient package. And the first thing that they offer is their electric toothbrush. Now, this thing is not like your other janky, heavy electric toothbrushes. This thing is a thing from the future. And the first thing that it does, it has timed electric vibrations that happen every 30 seconds to give you a dentist recommended perfect 2-minute clean. It's a lightweight, sleek design. It's perfect for adults and kids with no wires or bulky charger to weigh you down. It's also super incredibly easy to travel with. It's got a nice, convenient traveling case that you can carry anywhere you go. And the multi-use travel cover doubles as a mirror mount for less clutter when you're out on the go. This brush also has reusable handles, which come in a range of sleek metal hues, including all black and all pink. Now, with the free to download Quip app, you can not only keep track of and improve your brushing, but you can also get rewards like free refills and Target gift cards just for keeping track of when you brush your dang teeth. Now, Quip also offers fresh floss, anti-cavity toothpaste, refillable mouthwash, refillable gum, and all of these things you can get every 3 months for just $5 and up. Their shipping is free, so you can save money and skip the hustle and bustle from going in-store shopping. And don't forget, these stylish and affordable electric brushes start for just $25. Good habits lead to good health. I fully believe that, and that's why I really like these guys as today's sponsor. So if you're interested in getting started for yourself, go to getquip.com/corridorcast. That's getquip.com/corridorcast. And when you do that, you're gonna get started with your first refill for free. Okay, that's getquip.com/corridorcast, or just click the link in the description below.
Quip, the good habits company.
So anyways, huge thanks to them for sponsoring. And now back to the episode.
Looking into next year, guys, we're trying to do all these shows. I was, and we played ourselves last year when we didn't start production on any of these shows until they were fully greenlit. Mm-hmm. So the question is like, A, how are we confident that our ideas will get greenlit? What if we put one out there and we're already in development on it, and everyone on the site is like, yo, this show sounds like a friggin' terrible idea. We don't want anything to do with it. I guess we stop, right? But assuming that they're at least decent and people like them, then... You know, we gotta get to work now on these, I think. And because what happened last year, we're still wrapping up Local Zero. Wrapping it up, we haven't even hardly, you know, gotten into
the official production, pre-production phase. But script writing's done. and like true pre-production of like, oh, let's start building this out. That's going now.
And that's a huge, huge, huge place from where we came from, because when we started the Greenlight project for that, we hadn't even gone through the steps of like proving the concept at that point even. So, but we got that. We still got to wrap that up. That's from late or early last year. And then, but I was looking, and if we do Son of a Dungeon and then maybe Wizard Cops, we could potentially put ourselves in a scenario where later next year, maybe like August or so, we do season 3 Son of a Dungeon and then right into a full season of a new show, maybe Wizard Cops. And then we roll right in from that into season 3 Crew Cuts. And that to me sounds like a heck of a time.
That does sound like a heck of a time.
That's wild.
It would be like, it would be 8 episodes of Son of a Dungeon, probably 6 episodes of the next show. So that would be like 2 plus straight months from early August to the end of October. Almost 3 months of exclusive shows.
Well,
hopefully.
Jeez. I mean, now,
that's cool.
Sounds awesome.
It would be awesome. We got a little work to do. I got to start building out the actual productions for these now, like a real boy. Because when we went into Son of a Dungeon, it was like, okay, we'll make a spreadsheet for it and we'll sort of knock out the costs for the team and all that stuff. But man, you know, those days of ease are gone. Mm. We're operating at a new level now, gentlemen.
What makes it a lot harder with the budget specifically?
Well, you just have to track the budget a lot closer, because last year we didn't quite know how much we had to work from, you know.
Okay.
So it's kind of this general principle of like, well, don't spend more than we usually do, rather than like, okay, now let's actually specifically like cut away and allocate so that we have, you know, we can sort of tranche out like what our expense is for these shows. Obviously within reason, you know, there's still going to be a little bit of figuring it out as we go because the whole thing's still growing, but
sure.
Yeah.
But at least, you got the experience under our belts here doing this first season. Mm-hmm, so that's great.
And then we still owe, Dubstep Guns 10 years later. It's not Dubstep Guns 10. It's Dubstep Guns 2, but I call it Dubstep Guns X. Dubstep X.
X. Yeah.
So Mike's super excited about that. I was talking with him today and
oh, nice.
Yeah, I think we can shoot that in like March, which would be great.
Cool. I'm excited too. I'm very excited. That's a fun little short.
So
how many years ago was the first one?
2011.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, it was 10 years ago.
Oh, that's very simple math
that's where the X came from.
That I could have done very quickly in my head.
Remember the title that we talked about?
Yes,
it
makes
now.
A lot of sense.
XI, yeah.
The Romans invented a system of numerals to...
it's like, what the VI is, the 10?
What if we use these letters for numbers, too?
You know, as smart as they were, they really messed up on the number front.
Yeah, I got all these letters lying around. What are we going to do with them?
Just lying around. You might as well use them for something.
Might as well put these letters on some clocks.
What does X mean?
Too.
Well, no, we use that for words. Like, okay, it's 10 now.
Yeah.
Like, okay.
When it's next to a V, it means 15. Yeah, they really messed up on the numbers front, guys.
Yeah.
I mean, let's just point that out. They could have created a system of 0 to 9 and like, you know, Arabic numbers, but they really...
Yeah, it's just
They screwed up on the 4 in particular.
Yeah, the 4.
The 4 features a 5?
Right.
Right.
You've lost me.
Yeah.
And the 9 features a 10.
Yeah, I'm no longer interested in your
It's a
your
weak 5 is what it is. It's a weak 5.
The
a disappointing 5.
Features a 10.
It was a weak sentence. It didn't want to come out all the way.
It's all right, buddy.
Just like the 5.
We all have that issue occasionally.
Yeah, all right.
Well,
so that's what's going on. I don't know if you guys want to talk about other projects you're working on, if we just want to continue playing single player D&D for the rest of this podcast.
I can't handle it. You guys are not being compliant enough.
Yeah, you definitely have the most work.
When you tell us to make the rules up, I'm going to figure out a way to not die.
Yeah.
Nah, look, I'm going to be a lot harder on you guys if we ever play this again. Like, I was honestly,
I died in the first.
Can
two
we do one
minutes?
More round?
Right? So,
can we do one more round?
Quick. Let's do
another
round.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right,
yeah.
You open your eyes and you're flying through the sky at 1,000 miles an hour.
Jordan or me?
And you realize that you were just on a plane. but you can't see the plane.
Just who are you speaking to?
To Jake. You're gonna die quick.
Are you speaking to me?
Yeah, I'm speaking to you, Jake. Okay. What languages do you speak? What's your character like? Give me some. How many health points do you have?
I speak Mandarin, and I have 8 health points.
So you're like a level one. Yeah. Like
I'm
like
a level
Chinese.
One human yeah.
person
who aspires to be a warlock.
Okay, the ground's coming up pretty quick.
I only know some simple warlock cantrips, and so I reach out to the ethereal plane to try to get one of the demons that's I'm trying to train from to help me. In Mandarin, of course.
Okay,
yeah,
just making sure.
Okay, yeah,
that's the only language I speak.
Okay, so yeah, you hit the ground. You're dealt like 50
good.
Points of damage.
That was a rough one.
I guess that's it.
That was a rough one, man.
Oh, you should have had more health points.
That was really cool, though. I think you should be a warlock again. Yeah. I think that's a really cool class, honestly.
You think that fits me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Good.
Oh, man.
All right,
well,
next?
That's it. Yeah, bravo. Nah, I can't keep doing this. Yeah. Like,
it's so easy for
they're
us.
They're all in the same way.
I would just like to say Matt is still alive, like, so they do not
that's
end
true.
The same
I
way.
I am alive still. I haven't
but
finished
you have to
realize,
like, have to I end don't the same decide way. Where the story goes. It's up to the players, you know?
They don't all have to
end why I'm still alive.
This is collaborative storytelling here. I'm not calling all the shots. I'm just setting the scene.
It sounds like victim blaming, actually.
Come on, one more. Let's go.
I want to see what happened to Jordan.
Yeah,
Jordan. What?
Can I get resurrected?
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah, Jordan. Just back like the back of Jordan storyline. So, yeah, roll me a death saving throw.
Okay, get a 16.
Oh, you're back. You're alive. You have one hit point left.
Oh, sick.
You wake up naked as the rats scurry away, and much of your body has been eaten away at.
That's
but
unfortunate.
You wake up in darkness.
Oh, nice. And Jake's old character is there, right?
Jake's old character from the other storyline. Okay. So you wake up and you feel next to you and you feel what seems to be some sort of like exploded corpse with bones, broken bones jutting out.
I am missing body parts that he might have, so I get into his remaining body to fill the holes.
Okay,
do you know like blood magic or something?
Like necromancy?
I'm just
or
getting in it. I don't know anything. I'm naked and alone. Getting in the body.
Well, you notice that the rats all no longer are interested in you for some reason.
I feel hideous.
You feel hideous. But anyways, it's still completely dark.
It's cold down here. Any way out of this thing, or am I just gonna die in this?
Come on, throw a rope around the rats or something, and have them scurry you up the wall.
Oh, you hear a door open, and lantern torchlight shines into the room, and you see a dark silhouette standing 10 feet away from you.
I say,
it's Matt's
hello?
Character.
You see him raise a crossbow and aim it at you.
Oh, good lord!
No.
He says, "Anyone still alive in here?"
I lay perfectly still.
It's like you, the one who spoke moments ago. Are you still alive?
I sit still and I hope that he doesn't see me.
It's like perhaps he's
roll
died.
Roll a stealth check. Come on.
He rolls the investigation check to see if you are dead, and he fails it and thinks you're dead. He's like,
I'm doing great. Yeah. I just continue to wade in the old body of Jake.
And he, under his breath, he says, I heard a loud thump in here.
I feel like my situation now is worse than death. Let's be real. I'm not winning this game.
And so, you see that.
I'm limbless in an old body.
He fires a crossbow bolt at your general direction. It flies right next to you and hits not your body, but the corpse. And doesn't actually hit you. It hits the corpse, and then he closes the door and leaves and locks it, and you're trapped in darkness again.
Okay. I choose to flip my fingers. What are you doing?
You can just wait, too. You can say, I decide to wait 10 years. You can just if you want to pass time faster, just let me know.
I summon the spirit of the nude god, Matt.
See what was happening in the meantime. Meanwhile. I was continuing to dig down. as far as I can dig down.
As you dig down.
I'm in a hole, and I've just kept digging.
Actually, yeah, a hole, as you keep digging.
With my godly digging powers. My godly ability to move dirt with my hands slowly at a
Your
human
character
pace.
Is some level of God.
Talk about two extremes here.
Oh, yeah, so as you dig, you notice the ground starts giving and quickly starts falling away. Roll a dex saving throw to hold onto a nearby root. Or decide to just plummet into the pit.
I got a 15.
Oh, then you hold onto the roof and the ground gives way beneath you again.
Yay!
My hero.
And light shines down into a dim hole where you see a nude man wrapped in broken bones, mostly surrounded by rats.
Do the rats look friendly?
They're minding their own business.
Okay.
Yeah, they're not
like
way
smiling
with me already.
Or offering you anything.
I pull out a tiny harp that I have on me.
I asked you about this. How are you? Where are you keeping this tiny harp? You're naked.
I'm saying it's tiny.
Well,
we can imply.
Look, all
things.
I know is that on his character sheet it says he has two harps.
Yes.
And like I it's just he has.
Where's
them.
The other one?
He has two harps.
Nobody knows.
Who's to say except me? But anyway, I have the tiny harp. I play it with my fingers.
You could be holding it. Just
in
your hand.
It's about this. It's about this big.
2 inches wide. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Of a harp, and I start playing it for the rats.
Oh,
and
it's not
tiny
for me.
Music
okay.
for rats. Just to make sure that they're calm and tranquil as I.
The same strategy I see with the wolves, where you play music for animals.
Yes. Unfortunately, my big harp is. I left it. It's in the shop.
It's unfortunate.
Okay. All the rats begin moving and swarming to the center of the room where. The light and dirt has just fallen down. They're trying to form a pile to come up closer to the music. Straight beneath you.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm going to use the rats as sort of a ladder.
Are
they
you
close
leaving
enough
me now?
To me where I can...
To descend
well, I'm
down
climbing down.
The
yeah,
hole.
It's about like a 15-foot drop where it's like you can't climb down the rats, but you could certainly use them as a crash pad.
Okay, I'm going to use them as a crash pad.
So you drop down into the pile of rats, and I'm going to roll damage for your fall. So it's only like... Oh, okay, but yeah, that kills half the rats.
Yeah, I'm quite heavy.
So you smush half the rats, and the others run away and flee.
Yeah, okay.
So you're standing in this room with rat guts under your feet, and there's a man sitting unmoving silently next to another exploded corpse.
Come visit me.
Surrounded by bones.
Me. Hello, who goes there?
Just a nude, half-eaten, lonely boy.
Yeah, I can see most of your skeleton.
Yes.
Do you like my harp music?
My work is done here. You guys take it from here.
Oh, look at this. Yes.
Well, now this is two-player D&D.
No, it's still three-player. But you guys, see, let's see where this
starts. Conjure Cure Wounds on him. He looks injured.
Yeah, do that. That sounds good.
I conjure Cure Wounds on you. As a god, a godly curing of wounds.
I'm kind of digging
sort
the
of
new limbs that I got.
He's fully healed.
Sort
and
of
all
the Jesus.
All his wounds are restored. He's like buff and shiny now.
Yeah, I'm still
great.
Kind of like diddling my harp with the two fingers.
And I watch you diddle in the dark.
Yep.
That's
well. I mean, there is that.
Like a nice happy ending.
There's a little bit of light shining through now because of the holy creator. So you can see him completely. But anyways, you're both naked and alone.
Shall we try to, is this your friend down here?
I mean, I think we already won, Matt.
Hey, wait, did you
hear
you
our situation?
Me?
You kind of won.
Yeah, I'm trying to see if we can get Jake back here. Okay?
Oh,
reanimate me.
Can you
so
not
sorry.
Just give up that
well,
easily?
See,
Jesus Christ.
But I ripped into him.
This is like the Avengers
parts of
right
him
now,
are
by
in
the way.
Rats.
Because, like, we're used to the game with Jordan and me. That was awesome. And then the story with Matt and me was cool, but left unfinished. Obviously, Jake's storyline is really cool, but it's weird how we rebooted it to the other storyline.
Yeah.
And but now it's like crazy because like
they're all merging.
All these storylines are like merging in the same game.
Yeah, all your favorite characters
it's like
are
some
back.
It's like metaverse.
Can you
D&D
please,
cinematic
can you
universe?
Please perform some necromancy and reanimate me.
Okay,
yeah, that's fine. I'll just chill over
I think
here
that
in the
ball's
corner.
In your court. I don't know how to do
mean,
that.
I don't really have any skill sets or clothes, so I'm kind of.
Okay, I perform.
You're just a buff level one human.
Yes.
I have a son that did this a long time ago.
Okay.
Jesus Christ is who I'm referring to.
So you are God.
Oh,
I mean, you
this is
are
a Christian
the
pantheon?
Father.
Not necessarily. I'm like kind of all the gods.
Oh, I see.
Kind of wrapped up into one. Yeah.
Nice.
Wow.
Yeah.
You are
it's sort of
omnipotent.
Yeah. It's sort all of a variety powerful. Pack of gods that I can just sort of choose which one I want
Universal.
At any given time. So let me just try this. I necromance and my hands
are
shaking.
Like,
performing.
Yeah, it's a resurrection.
Sort of a resurrection thing happening.
Okay,
here.
Yeah. I mean, he casts resurrection and Jake comes back to life.
Oh.
Wow. So, yeah. So, I said that so casually.
Yeah.
It's a golden light spills from your hands and a warm glow and sparkles begin swirling the form. And mutated broken bones and body parts begin congealing and liquefying, and you see the form of Jake magically reappear.
Oh,
and
what a moment.
Before you lies an unconscious nude Jake.
You're naked too, by the
way. Everyone's naked, by the way. We're all
should
naked.
Should we hold hands and just walk out of here? Just the Spider-Man meme just looking at each other.
Hey,
well,
guys.
It's not my fault you guys did that. That
Matt,
was like literally
thank
your
you
everyone
yeah
this is
for
like
bringing me back to
your
life
fault.
Hey it was my pleasure to do it. Didn't know I could.
I knew you could do it all along because you're omnipotent and
as a corpse. You knew that?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, yeah, well, you're omnipotent, right? You're like universally God.
Yeah, I felt
so
your
obviously
spirit.
You knew that I knew that.
I felt your spirit kind of like cheering me on the sidelines, so I appreciate that. That's kind of why I wanted to you know, give you.
Oh. So as you look life. Up, you see there's wolves looking over the hole.
Oh goodness.
Hey, why don't we? Can I propose an idea?
There's five wolves looking down the hole now.
Let's go to the top of that hole. Let's kill those wolves.
It's 100 feet.
Yeah,
but you dug 100 feet.
We don't have enough rats anymore.
Rat bone ladder. Rat bone ladder.
I think you guys keep forgetting we are with God. So
I could just fly.
Yeah, I don't need a rat bone ladder.
Can you guys just grab onto my hands and I'll just levitate
up? Can we go
up
to the top of there? Can we harvest those wolves, take their fur, and then eat their meat? And then we'll have clothes and food.
They're going to be disappointed about that because they're my friends now.
We'll keep one that'll become our pet.
Okay,
that
sounds good. Yeah, I
or
am
maybe,
a
maybe
harsh
a couple.
And,
maybe a couple. That way we can keep the pack going.
Yeah, I am a cruel god. I'm like the Old Testament god. I don't care. So let's do it. You go. And I reach out my arms.
Okay,
so
I'll grab an arm.
I'll grab one.
Can I choose to interlace fingers?
Interlace fingers.
Yes.
Okay.
For strong grip. Yeah.
Yep. Right. Strong grip. Exactly. Strong. That was my only
interesting choice, but
to do that.
I don't interlace my fingers because I know what's going to happen. We're going to get up there either way.
Thank you.
Oh yeah. Well, so you grab hands and you begin levitating.
Yep. I've levitated
upward. Okay. So you have to roll. You guys have to roll strength checks to hold on to his hands.
Oh,
okay.
Goodness.
This is a very one-handed.
Yeah, it's pretty tough.
And you're all slippery and
dirty. I'm buff now.
Oh yeah.
That's true. I mean, he's a beefcake.
I got some forearms.
It's a 14.
Okay, you're great. You hold on tight.
Oh,
I got
great.
I got a 15.
Oh yeah, you guys are great.
Not a competition.
Go right up to the hole, and as you pass the wolves, you draw five attacks of opportunity.
Dang it!
They're trying to bite you.
Oh wait, guys, I thought we were friends. What the hell?
Yeah, the music faded. It wore off after all the digging. Like this is like hours later, maybe. Who knows?
I try to use my tiny harp, but
so,
it's very
quiet.
Yeah,
Jake does a 14 and a 16 hit.
Yes.
Okay, roll me another. Okay, you take 6 points of damage and roll a dex saving throw to see if your hand slips.
Okay.
See if they break your grip.
Oh, you have dice.
It's a 10.
Oh, shoot. You slip and fall down 100 feet.
Dang it. Oh, dang
there
it.
He goes.
Oh,
and
no.
You're dealt, I'm rolling it, 23 points of damage.
Okay, I'm still alive. I mean, remember, I'm
shattered
a wizard.
Legs.
I'm
you're back at the bottom of the pit.
I'm a 300-year-old wizard. Don't forget.
That is true.
Wait, are you the guy who came in the room? No, you're already dead.
Jordan,
I'm get to the
a 13 and a 15 hit.
Heck yeah.
Yes. Yeah,
is that good?
Okay.
Good
you
Lord.
Take 12 points of damage and roll me a dex saving throw.
Okay. 11.
You fail and you fall 100 feet back down to the pit.
I'm home.
You're dealt 36 points of damage and I think that kills you again.
Wow.
No, you know, it's finally over.
It's finally over.
And I continue to levitate upward.
So you fall down and crash to the ground. Moments later, Jordan flies down and falls to his death. And Matt just flies away.
He just keeps going.
Just
a choir of angels.
Skin bag at the bottom of the pit.
I didn't actually notice.
Honestly, this.
Sam.
Yeah, I take my head.
An asteroid hits the planet, everyone blows up. It's the end.
Damage. Oh,
deals
I
you
take,
5 trillion points of damage. Does
I
that
take
kill
out
you?
My tiny. I take out my tiny ocarina.
No, Jake, you're dead. You're dead. You just got about 5 trillion points of damage.
No, we didn't. Nope.
Shit. I just love that God dropped me and then just kept going.
Yeah.
And I play.
I was on a vibe.
Okay, yeah, sure. I'll give you one bonus action before the asteroid hits.
Yeah, can I take a bonus action, please?
Nice.
Take a bonus action.
Resurrect me so we can see it out together.
I play my ocarina. Yeah. And I call for my giant eagle to come save us. Mm.
So the eagle flies, but the asteroid hits it first because it's higher up.
Nice, nice.
And then dealing it 5 trillion points of damage. Then it plummets through the ground, hits you. 5 trillion points of damage.
Man.
You can roll a dex saving throw.
I roll a dex saving throw.
Or just,
I roll a dex saving throw.
You managed to... Well, okay, roll me dex saving
20,
throw against
it's
like
a... It's a 20.
It's a natty 20?
No, not natty 21. With a modifier. It's a 21.
Oh, if it was a natty 20, I would let you roll out of the way, but but no, it hits.
Come on.
Fuck it. You roll out of the way. Yes. Your planet gets destroyed behind you. You're left there floating
just
in space.
That one little piece of... Am I on that with him?
Okay, and
we were next to each other.
You're dead.
Remember,
you're dead.
That's devastating.
I was just with a bunch of cloud giants, and I play my little harp again, or my little whistle, and I call them to come and take me up to their cloud land.
Okay. That works.
More cake.
And you see a cloud nimbus and a cloud giant fly through, and they see you floating in space. I mean, I don't know how the clouds are there right now, but they still are.
Space clouds.
They're cloud giants, right?
Yeah.
Maybe they're on a celestial cloud.
Maybe this is a celestial cloud, yes. That would make sense. Yeah, all right, I've just changed it. It's a celestial one. Yeah.
Stardust. Okay, great. And I was like, guys, did you see that?
I think we'll
meteorite?
Have to continue this one later, Jake. Jake, this is getting a little interesting. I need to prepare a little bit more before we go down this storyline.
Dang
yeah.
it. I was really having fun there.
Yeah.
I was just using what you were giving me, man.
Yeah, me too. I was just using what you're giving me. Just working that into the storyline.
I'm sure the
you're still ascending.
I'm sure listeners are going to be at the edge of their seats. Mm-hmm.
And
finding
that,
out what
kids,
happens next
is
week.
How you write a story.
There you go. Well, it wasn't really single player D&D at the end there.
Yeah.
So, yeah, kind of ruined the joke a little bit, but up until that point, I think we're on to something.
Yeah. I was satisfied with my
funny,
decisions.
It is funny how, and you brought this up last week in the podcast, and I reiterated it, but one of the core tenets of writing is you put characters in a room together, and then you're just like,
yeah, you put.
I don't know what's gonna happen, but
three naked adventurers and a pit of rats together, something's gonna happen.
You put enough interesting
one
characters
turns
in
into
a
god.
Room together.
One right. interlaces fingers with
gone.
That god.
One dies twice. The other one dodge rolls away from an asteroid
onto a celestial cloud.
Dex saving throw away from
into
an
space.
Asteroid.
Oh, that's fun.
All right.
I like that.
That was interesting. I think that's one of the farthest tangents we've ever taken this podcast.
Mm. Yeah, seriously. Wow. Yeah, it was a deep what and a complex thrill. Tangent that had rules and stakes.
It did.
Yeah. I hope y'all enjoyed it, listener.
Anyways, so that is the end of the Corridor Cast podcast. Yes. This is the finale. This is the finale of our podcast.
Epic finale.
This is the final episode of the Corridor Cast. It's over. It's done.
We got to have a sick like end title. Some 3D title.
Let's do a post-credits scene as well here.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
We'll do a special post-credits scene at the very end of the podcast.
Yeah. I like that.
It'll be the first 5 minutes where your microphones weren't working.
There you go. Yeah.
Just us talking.
It's like, what happened to Jake? Where did Matt go? Will Jordan make a new character? Will he ever play D&D with us again?
No.
I'm done. Yeah. That's it.
Yeah.
It's a one and done for him.
that's a one shot. Yeah. We call that a one shot.
I live my best life already.
That's it. Okay, but next week we're going to be talking about what people do for Thanksgiving. Think about that. Mm-hmm.
What people in general do, or what
I
want to
hear the traditions. I want to hear what people's little traditions are for Thanksgiving.
Okay,
and I want to get into that next week.
Right, let's kick it off. let's pull that into this podcast.
No, we
this
not
is the after credits
podcast.
I want to talk about that right now.
No. Nope. Sorry. Nope.
Most overrated Thanksgiving food.
Oh, that, whatever, that Jell-O mashed potato salad thing?
Oh.
What is that?
Squash?
Cranberry sauce? Cranberry sauce.
No, it's like a Jell-O.
Sauce is incredible. Are you serious?
It's a little overrated.
No, I'm not talking about the canned stuff, though. I'm talking about real cranberries.
Oh, okay.
Real and made crayons. Into a sauce. Them real crayons.
With the turkey, that can be good.
Those true crayons.
True crayons.
The true crayon.
What about, like, sweet potatoes?
Sweet potato casserole, I'm not on board with.
Yeah.
Like, with the marshmallows and shit, I can leave that at the
maybe that's what I'm thinking of. This has marshmallows or Jell-O or something in it.
Okay.
And
well,
it's wrong.
I hope it doesn't have both. That's
That'd be real charming if you walked into like a family Thanksgiving, especially if it's not your family, and you look at some sweet potato casserole and you're like, you can leave that at the door.
Yeah, you can literally leave that for the dogs at the door.
Keep that outside.
The pack of wolves that are out front.
Yeah, the tamed wolves.
That we kept alive. Somehow they survived an asteroid strike. I don't know how.
Can we play Thanksgiving D&D too?
Thanksgiving
themed D&D.
Yeah, let's do that.
All right.
This is a weird one, guys.
This is such a weird podcast.
Yeah,
if you're listening at this point,
no, you didn't.
Then,
it's great.
Then congratulations. We got plenty more to come.
Yep. It only gets weirder on the next episode.
Silence.
That's it. So
is that the cut point?
That's the cut point.
I hope so. I really hope so.
It's like, yeah, we'll just trim it right there. But the thing is, it's still going.
It's still going. Yeah, now they're at the edge of their seats thinking, like, when is it actually going to end?
Yeah.
Is it going to keep going forever? Is this forever?
Yes.
Or are we just going to
This
gonna
is
get,
our reality
are we
now.
Just going to start talking quieter and quieter?
And just fade as out as, like, a fade guitar out. Fades in and just a seamless
Well, but if we cut, there's no post-credit.
There's no post-credits. Like,
the little hint at the next game.
Maybe this is the post-credits.
Mm-hmm.
Before the credits.
Oh, this is weird.
This is post-credits before credits.
This is
credits.
Getting weirder and weirder and weirder.
I'm going to be driving home wondering what happened.
Like...
Someone needs to come in here with
like
a gun
happened?
And end this.
Like, we were supposed to do a podcast.
It's a fever dream at this point.
Does this count as a podcast?
I feel like I'm
fever
tripping.
Fever dream. Fever
There's
dream.
Is this the point?
Is there a way out of it?
All right, let's talk
There's
about
no.
other things.
We
all
can't.
All right, here we go. Let's
we're
reinvigorate.
Done. We're done.
Oh,
okay.
We're done.
No, we're not cutting. We haven't cut yet, right?
Christian already cut.
Cut.